While no longer found in the continent, the history of birdsmen in the continent of Africa is long and storied, with many species and quite some mysteries. While I can't put all the details in them, I hope I've put enough relevant details in, and I really hope that you check out many of these species to learn further information that I couldn't put in this one. Perictus was a small early bear famous for its finds in North America, but it also lived in Africa as well. These were some of the earliest known bears, and they were still very primitive as far as bears go, being small and dog-like and raccoon-like. After these humble beginnings, more advanced forms would come to Africa in the form of the Hamiciones, or the dog bears. These wolf-like bears were predatory and even hypercarnivorous. They likely hunted down other animals and ate them, similar to how animals with that build do today. They are not to be confused with the bear dogs, which also grew to similar sizes but were not bears, but instead related carnivorans. Next, we move on to Indarctos, a species that actually lived throughout much of the Old World, from North America, through Eurasia, all the way into Africa. They are believed to have lived in the Miocene epoch, but some African finds suggest that late surviving bears might have lived into the early Pliocene. Despite being a widespread bear, much about the bear's life and even its diet are quite uncertain. Agriophium was a prehistoric bear that lived in Africa, particularly in South Africa. This is particularly because they are the only bears known to live there. These were among the biggest known bears known to paleontologists, and they were likely omnivores like today's bears. Ursus minimus was widespread throughout the Old World and is believed to have been present in North Africa as well. At only around 100 pounds, they were rather small, but they are believed to have been the common ancestor of most of today's bears. The much larger Etruscan bear later succeeded Ursus minimus in colonizing North Africa. These bears are significant because they are the ancestors of today's brown or grizzly bears and the Ice Age cave bears that many of us know today. And my gosh, were those cave bears really, really big. The Atlas bear is often cited as the only known undisputed bear population to live in Africa in historic times. Typically described as a subspecies of the brown bear, occasionally it gets described as a species in its own right due to how different it was in physical appearance and behavior. It was said to be a dark brownish black bear with a black muzzle, orange brown underparts, and short but stout claws, unlike the long claws brown and grizzly bears typically have. The claws were described as being dark color or even black, but many brown or even grizzly bear claws can also be brown or black. They were often captured by the Romans to fulfill gladiator spectacles, where they were often mistreated to make them more aggressive. Roman logging projects in the Atlas Mountains, their habitat, also contribute to their demise. According to David Day, this allowed the Sahara to expand, which was something that the Atlas bears, who were adapted for forest life, could not handle. For centuries to come, they clung on to the most remote areas in the Atlas Mountains into the 19th century. It took it to the 19th century for scientific descriptions and studies to actually be made on the bear. Much of what we know about the bear comes from a man named Crowfer, who observed and studied the bear, and for which the scientific name of the bear commemorates. The advent of the repeating rifle finally put the nail in the coffin, and by the 1870s they were extinct. The Syrian brown bear is a subspecies of the brown bear, native to the Middle East, that is unfortunately now endangered. They live throughout much, if not most, of the Middle East, and are the bears described in the Bible. They lived at least as far south as the Sinai Peninsula of Egypt in recorded history, and possibly even farther south. If so, they would have been another kind of bear living in Africa in recorded history, though not necessarily in modern times. The Atlas bear still holds that distinction. There were also two other possible subspecies, but I couldn't find much information of them at the time of making this video, so I didn't add them in. Well, this took longer than I thought it would. Originally I was going to make a Did You Know video, but I decided to make this instead. I was always fascinated with the bears that used to live in Africa, and I wanted to spread this knowledge with others too, so that other people would know about these once glorious African bears. Well, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.